Assalamu alaikum, dear student. So in a previous lecture I discussed about Bowman capsule. Now in this lecture I will discuss the composition of glomerulus basement membrane. Before discussing glomerulus basement membrane in detail, you should know that here are present afferent arterioles, coming afferent arterioles, which divide and give branches, and these branches are called glomerulus capillaries. These again reunite and give branches another arteriole, which is called efferent arteriole. It is important to know that the diameter of efferent arteriole is about half to that of efferent arteriole. These are the podocytes, and this layer form the endothelial cell. It is important to know that glomerulus basement membrane is common for podocyte as well as endothelial cell of the capillaries. Now I am going to discuss this glomerulus basement membrane in detail. So dear student, this is glomerulus basement membrane. These are the podocytes, and these are the pedicels between which are present slit diaphragms, slit membranes. This is the basement membrane, and this is common for endothelial cell. These are the endothelial cell which make the blood capillaries, and these black lines represent podocytes. These are the endothelial cell also on opposite sides. This is the endothelial this is the glomerulus capillary. So this is glomerulus basement membrane. If we enlarge this structure, it will give three regions. So Bowman capsule is consisted of three regions, and it is also important to know that the diameter of glomerulus basement membrane is different in children as compared to the adults or old people. In children, glomerulus basement membrane is about 150 nanometer, while in adults or old people it is about 300 nanometer. It means that with the age it increases in thickness. So it is to be noted that glomerulus basement membrane consists of three layers. One is the lamina rara externa. Lamina rara externa. This is the lamina rara externa. Another is lamina rara densa, and other is lamina rara interna. Each layer is their own composition, but the composition of lamina rara interna is approximately same as that of lamina rara externa, while the lamina rara densa have different composition. First of all, you should know that this lamina rara externa is located toward the podocyte region, which form the visceral layer of the cell. These are the podocytes present here, and these are the pedicels. These are the podocyte cells. Okay, having oval nucleus, you should know that oval nucleus is present in podocytes. These are the pedicels, these are the podocytes, and here is what? Endothelial cells of the glomerulus capillaries, having gaps between them. Okay, so each layer is their own composition. It is important to know that in lamina rara interna there are present glycosaminoglycane, heparin sulfate, and also present glycoprotein, which include limonene and fibronectin. So here is present glycosaminoglycane, heparin sulfate, and which is negative in charge. Also present here glycoproteins, and this glycoprotein includes limonene and fibronectin. These are the two glycoprotein. It is important to know that lamina rara interna has approximately same composition to that of lamina rara externa. So these can be written here: glycosaminoheparin sulfate, in short words I'm writing, and limonene and fibronectin. These are also present here. In the medial region, which is called rara densa, is present collagen proteins. And which type of collagen protein are present here? Collagen type 4 protein is present here. And it is important to know that this collagen type 4 protein form a sieve-like structure. It forms sieve. What is sieve? Sieve is this like structure which help in filtration. And this filter the molecule according to their size. It is important to know that glycosaminoglycan heparin sulfate is negative charge, so it prevent the movement of negative substances through this glomerular basement membrane. It clear that positive substances which have size smaller can pass through this region, but negative substances cannot pass through this region because negative charge of glycosaminoglycan heparin sulfate repel these substances. The medial region is collagen type 4, which form a tube. This sieve help in filtration, but it prevent those molecules which are greater than the pores of the sieve. And same is the composition of this region. Now we have to discuss glomerular capillaries. These are the glomerular capillaries. These capillaries have gaps between them. They consist of endothelial cells, and these endothelial cells have gaps. These are the endothelial cells. These endothelial cells have gap between them. So it means that they can filter different types of substances. And these substances include sodium and potassium and etc. bicarbonate ion. So I am writing here, these endothelial cells are also covered by glycocalyx. And it is important to know that efferent arteriole bring blood to these capillaries, and if efferent arteriole bring blood away from these capillaries. This is Bowman capsule, and these are the glomerulus arteries. So here different substances are filtered. This is important to know that I am going to any structure. For example, these substances include sodium ion, potassium ion, bicarbonate ion, also glucose, and also amino acids. These substances are filtered here. So this is all about glomerulus basement membrane and glomerulus capillaries. So you should know about this.